The second task in this series is to create a game, and here we'll be learning all about conditionals. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code, but Scratch program is easier as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together, and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. Again, in this video, we'll include the instructions, although you only really need to just follow how we put the blocks together. If you do want to read the instructions, then just pause the video. But just follow along and see how we create the program, putting the blocks together. Make sure you subscribe, then you'll know when the videos are released. You start off by removing the cat and getting a new sprite. So we go to the library and we need the ball. So now we have the ball sprite. We're going to move 10 steps. So I drag the block there, I make it bigger so it's easier for you to see. And now if we click, you can see here the block moves 10 steps, the ball moves 10 steps. We now add an if on edge bounce block, which is also blue. So we put them together. Now we can go to control and we get a forever block. And we put the other blocks inside the forever block. And then we go to the events. And at the top we've got when green flag clicked. So now we can click the green flag and you can see the ball moves, and when it hits the edge, it bounces. So here's our first if statement, if on edge, bounce. If it's true, it hits the edge, the ball will bounce. Click the red dot to stop. Let's get a go-to block. So let's start the ball somewhere up here. We can see it's already give us an X and Y positions, so we can start that. And then that's where the ball's going to start. And then we want to point in direction 135. Now let's draw the baton. So we can go to choose a sprite and choose the paintbrush. So now we can draw something. So we can click on the rectangle because we want to draw a rectangle. The color, well, we're going to make it kind of black. So here's our color. So now we want to draw a rectangle. So if you draw a rectangle, you can see it come up in this area and you can move it. Perhaps we want to make it a bit more smaller than that. Let's try this size. Okay, that looks okay. Now it seems a bit confusing if you want to go back, but up in the top left you can see these tabs. So you have sound, costume and code. So now you're back to the code area. Now notice that the sprite called the baton is highlighted, not the ball. If we click on the ball, then we can see the blocks for the code. But the baton, we can rename that as pedal. And you can see that the code is connected to the sprite object. Now we want the pedal to move with the mouse, so we can use the sensing block. So here we have blocks relating to the movement. We can find block with mouse X, and we want to set X to that. So we put the mouse in set X to mouse X. We want that to happen all the time. So we can do the forever block around that and make sure it starts. So when green flag is clicked. So that code is under the paddle. So you can see the different codes for the different sprite objects. Now we're going to change the background. So we can click on this stage square here. And what we can do is we can add code to the background, the backdrop. In this example, we can add the paintbrush and we want to add another square, a rectangle. So we're going to make this a kind of reddish color. And we've selected this rectangle already. So we can make a small rectangle. We can make sure the outline is also red. And we can see in our stage area we have this red rectangle at the bottom. Good to make sure it covers the whole screen and it's right at the bottom. So that's fine. We now go back to our code and we go back to the ball. So we're going to add some more blocks on here. So we can add an if block. You can see here we want a condition. So the condition is that we're going to be touching the paddle. So we can use the touching block and there's a menu and we can select paddle and we can put that inside the if block. Now we want that to happen anytime. So we can put that in the forever block. What do we want to happen when the ball is touching the paddle? Well, the ball's going to come at an angle and we want it to bounce off at the correct angle from the paddle. We can use the motion blocks and we can find point in direction. Now, what are we going to put in this value? Well, we can use an operator and we're looking for the minus. And here, our direction is going to be 180 degrees minus the direction. So we can find the direction. So if we look at the motion blocks, we should find direction right down the bottom. So 180 minus direction. So that's green is an operator. And we can put that in point in direction. And we put that inside our if statement. So if the ball is touching the paddle, then point in direction 180 minus the direction. If it's not, it doesn't do anything. So that's our if statement. Now the ball's quite big, so we can change the size. We can change the size here in our command, or we can change it in our blocks. So if we go to look, we can look for the set size to and then the percentage sign. So we can change that to 60% and then we can move that so the ball changes before we run the code. So if we try that, we can see if we have our game, we click the green flag. And it starts, you can see the ball is bouncing off the side and bouncing off the paddle. So our if statements are working. To stop, we can hit the red circle. So finally, we want to end the game if the red rectangle is touched. So we can use another if block. And then we're going to have the sensing when touching color. Now we've fortunately got red here, but if you need to change the color, you can, for example, use the eyedropper and get that red. And now what we want to do, we want to say you lose if it touches the rectangle. So let's see if this works. Click the green flag. You can see it's bouncing correctly. And if we let it touch the red rectangle, then the game finishes, you lose. So here's the final look at all the blocks together. We set the size, placed where the ball starts and a point in the direction, and then we have a forever loop. And in that loop, we move steps, and if it hits the edge, it bounces. And then we have two more conditionals, if statements. If it's touching the paddle, we want it to bounce in the correct direction, which is 180 minus direction. And if it touches the red rectangle at the bottom, touching colour, then we finish the game by saying you lose for 2 seconds. So that's a code for the pong game. Now, maybe you want to try to make your own game, or even extend this game, maybe having a score, for example. So have some fun and just try different things and see what you come up with. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know. Enjoy your learning.